Last Christmas, I'll give you my heart. But the very next day, you give it away. This year, to set me from tears, I'll give it to someone special. Once bitter and twice shy, I keep my distance, but you still catch my eye. Tell me, do you recognize me? Well, it's been a year, it doesn't surprise me.
Så hva har vi her?
Kaffe.
Jeg mente kroppen, Kasper.
Ja.
Men takk for kaffen. Ja.
Mulig drap. Det er tydelige kvelermerker rundt halsen.
Noen mistenkte?
Nei. Men vi fant dette ved siden av kroppen.
Hva er det?
Mel.
Æsj! Urent mel i pose? Jeg tror du har rett, Kasper.
Dette var intet uhell.
Man is speaking.
Hello, this is Han Solo from the Norwegian Police Department.
A Norwegian, you say? Really? Well, I've actually tried lutefisk. Once on the way down, and another time on the way up.
Yeah. We need your help for a case here in Norway. How quickly can you plane over?
Tempus unum. Let me examine my calendar. Schedule checks out. I'll take the next flight.
Bra! Goodbye. Or as we say here in Norway, bye-bye on the toilet, your old piece of chocolate.
Right you are. Goodbye. Chocolate. Ruddy Norwegians, I tell you.
There's always so much pjat with them foreigners.
Old British people this way. Old British people this way.
Excuse me, sir, but why do all the British people have to venture this way?
Well, we have had some complaints from the Americans.
Typical, isn't it? Where are those Americans anyway?
Well, they're over there, being American.
On a scale from one America, I'm freer you than that.
As free as North Korea.
And they're over there.
Are you from Tennessee? Because you're the only 10, I see.
Ruddy Americans.
My mother's half American, you know.
Bugger.
Security.
Oh, hold deg ute!
Oh, bugger. How am I supposed to avoid falling if nobody tells me to mind the ruddy gap? Wasting their lives away. You've got to be kidding me.
Husker jeg gi dere noen jævlig gode tips til hvordan dere kan slippe under timen uten å lukte av etter læreren. Løper dere ned til Big Bang, tar Big Bang fra det går, tilbake igjen, opp igjen, stikker dere inn før dere tar fra dere. Så jævlig fort som mye høyere i halv.
Hvem er speaker?
Jeg kan ikke komme på en eneste god grunn for å bli lærer.
Jeg kan komme på tre.
Virkelig?
Ja. Juni, juli, august.
Pardon my abhorrent lateness. I was held back by a lovely conversation I had with a man on the tram. You know, I really do think we hit it off. Ha! or he have a case for me? Possible homicide. If so, has the murder weapon been obtained? Since you called upon me, I can only imagine that the utmost severe situation must have transpired.
I am sorry, but our English isn't that nice. Can we use a translator?
Well, I suppose. Sure, go ahead.
Kan du finne fram Google Translate?
Jeg fikser
det. Ja, takk.
Not Google Translate. I have bad experiences with them.
Nigeria, Google.
Well, it does no good to dwell upon the past. I'm off to talk to my first suspect. Wrapping up my conversation with the two detectives and quickly meeting the man with the plan.
Nice to meet you. My name is Leif Sigurdanielsen. You can call me Siggy Boy.
I decided to find the man they call the Bear, supporter of fire, whatever that means.
Hi, bro. How can I help you?
I was hoping you could tell me something about this.
Oh, drag me backwards through the Fogel case. This is the R.I.P. syndrome.
How can you live with yourself? Selling drugs to these intelligent... Selling drugs to these kind-hearted... Selling drugs to these kids.
You don't know. These children have to sit on those uncomfortable chairs day after day.
Just tell me who your biggest customer is.
Who do you think run this place?
After talking to the Bear, I needed a break from all the chit-chat. I decided to get some peace and quiet.
Good day, thank you. I was wondering if you'd perhaps seen anything suspicious around these parts.
Okay, so one time, at a funeral, one of the guests, he was blind. And he held a eulogy, a very, very good eulogy. And he wanted to give the dead person a gift. So he took his cane and he threw it in the grave. And all of a sudden, he could see. It was a miracle. So he left. And then a second person came along. He was in a white wheelchair.
Mm-hmm. All right, I see. Go on.
And then a third person came along. He was deaf. And he held a fantastic eulogy, signed a fantastic eulogy. And at the end he was like, what can I give you? Oh, and then he looked at his interpreter. And he tossed her in the grave. And a miracle, he could hear. And then he left.
I see. Thank you very much for your time.
I thought I'd stumble upon another dead end when my gaze suddenly fell upon a humorous poster on Trina's wall.
W-O-R-K. I've got it. Sorry, ladies, I think it's best I take my leave. Forgot this entire school's made of ruddy glass.
I know who the murderer is.
Oh! Hi.
Am I the only one working on this case?
I'll have you know, we've been working hardly on this case. You figure it out?
LSD. Leif Sigurd Danielsen.
Siggy boy?
Student council leader Frederick Hadjan, along with all the others before him, have been battling for years to get new chairs. Finally, Leif Sigurd gets to switch them, but Frederick did not approve of the new chairs.
Chairs Frederick didn't like? You're afraid he'll come back and take your life?
What life? I'm a married man.
Hey guys, I found something.
Life is life.
Life is life.
helvete kan ikke de rydde opp etter seg her?